So what is a trailing stop order in the Thinkorswim platform? In this video, I'm gonna walk you through the most effective way to set up and use the trailing stop order in Thinkorswim. Hey, how's it going? On this channel, you will learn the steps I took to go from trading with a full-time job to trading as a full-time job. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And at any point in the video, feel free to check out the notes and links in the description below. I'll list out any valuable resources down there. Now today, we're talking about the Thinkorswim platform and trailing stops. So the whole idea with the trailing stop order is so you don't have to do that manually yourself. Now, I'm just gonna come in here on the simulated trading platform and buy 100 shares of Apple for this demonstration. So I'm just gonna get long 100 shares of Apple, and then there are a few ways to set up a trailing stop loss order. Now, the first way you can do is you can come in here to the monitor tab and look at your positions. Now, you can look at your positions in here and then create a closing order for Apple, and then come in here and say sell with stop, and that'll be how you want to set that up. So then you can come in here and change this to a trailing stop. There isn't an easy tab for a trailing stop. So you just have to come in here and change the order type, and then you can set up your trailing stop for however far you want it. So maybe with Apple, you want, you know, 50 cent trailing stop or a dollar, depending on how you are trading. So we can come in here and say we want a dollar trailing stop, and because it's a sell order, we actually want to have this number be a negative number, so it's a dollar below the current price. And then we'll just click here, confirm and send that order in. And then we go over here to the chart and we can see that trailing stop order down here. Now, another way to do this is actually just while you can look at the chart, I can come on here and click the price up here and then click sell, because we want to sell, and then this will bring up a sell order down here, and then I can just come in here and click the trailing stop order and then shift that to a dollar as well, and that'll allow you to watch the price action on the chart so you don't have to be going back and forth trying to figure out how much of a trailing stop you want to put. So I'll put a dollar in here. You can go with mark for the link and the order type. That generally the default settings are really fine. And then you just want to click confirm and send, and then it'll calculate and it'll put that trailing stop down where you want. So this is pretty good trailing stop right now, because it looks like, you know, maybe this is where some support might be. And then as the market moves up, the trailing stop will move up with the market. So just to kind of zoom in or zoom forwards in time, to kind of show you what that will look like, as the stock moves up like this, the trailing stop here will start moving up as well. So hopefully once it gets high enough, the market will move up here and then eventually come down. Once it comes down, it'll hit your trailing stop, and that'll protect your profits and your potential gains that you had. So you can see that the trailing stop moved up a tiny bit with the market. And so this is essentially just how you set up a trailing stop. To quickly do that again for you, we can just come in here and minus this. We just go up here to the price, click sell because we are selling our position. And then again, the trailing stop. Also, you can see there's a trailing stop limit. And so I can actually come in here and make a trailing stop limit, which is basically a trailing stop, but you tell what price you want to then sell it at. So once it hits your trailing stop, instead of just selling out and selling at the market, you can sell at a certain price. So we can say that, okay, if it comes down 50 cents, we want to sell at this level down here. So like 220 and a half. So I can come in here and set that price for 220 and a half. And that is where that stop will then actually sell once it hits that price. So again, you'll have that trailing stop there and it will move with the market. Now, a quick way to go in and edit this is I can just come in here and right click on the actual order that you can see on your screen. And you can either cancel, copy, and then you can click replace order as well. And I can change that to a trailing stop again, and then maybe put it back to that 50 cents that we want, or a dollar. And then confirming and sending, and that'll hopefully update the trailing stop. And it will, as you can see, it moves up with the market. So as it is moving up with the market here, as the market moves up, that'll allow us to protect our profits as this trailing stop moves up with the market. And then we can either close out our position if maybe the market gets to a certain point, or we can just let this trailing stop run indefinitely and the stock will close out once it eventually hits that trailing stop. One thing you'll want to do if you do want the trailing stop to work overnight, this trailing stop we have right now will close at the end of the day. So if you want to do that, you're going to want to come in here and click replace order and just tell over here you want to change this day till GTC, and that just means good till canceled. And so that'll just run until it either gets filled or until the stock hits your trailing stop and that order gets filled. So again, that'll replace and that'll calculate. And that is just another way for you to use trailing stops over longer term timeframes. Hey, thanks for checking out this video. If you want to learn more about the Thinkorswim platform, make sure to check out my other Thinkorswim tutorials. Now, if you want to just learn more about the stock market and trading in general, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions on this video, don't hesitate to ask them in the comments below.